Hey everybody, Matthew here from MiniWarGaming.com, and in this video I'm going to talk about 5 big changes to command abilities and command points.
We play and call it work.
But before we get into that, don't forget that we have another Age of Sigmar 3rd Edition Battle Report for our wonderful Vault members at the link below. If you're not a Vault member, you can still click that link and get a free 7-day trial to watch that battle report and thousands of other videos. And of course, we hope you stick around afterwards to help to support us in making all of these videos. Number 1, command point generation. The way you gain command points has totally changed. First off, any command points that you don't use disappear at the end of the battle round. But at the beginning of every battle round, not the beginning of your hero phase, you gain 1 command point. The player who's going to be taking the second turn gets a bonus command point. Furthermore, at the start of each hero phase, if your general is on the table, you get another command point. This is important because in your opponent's hero phase, if your general is on the table, you'll get another command point. On top of that, there is something called a heroic action. In each of the hero phases, yours and your opponent's, you are allowed to do 1 heroic action with 1 hero. One of those potential ones is to try to gain another command point on a 4+ or a 2+ if your general is already dead. Number 2, who can issue commands? Now, it comes at no surprise that heroes can issue commands, but how that works has changed. No longer does each command ability have its own restrictions to how far away you have to be. Now, every hero can issue commands to a unit wholly within 12 inches. If it is a totem or your general, it can issue a command to a unit wholly within 18 inches. But probably the biggest change is the fact that a unit with a champion inside of it is allowed to issue a command to itself, which means those units can actually operate independently of other heroes being nearby. Number 3, command ability limits. Now there are some restrictions to how many command abilities you can use, who can issue them, and who can receive them. Every single phase, each hero or champion can only issue 1 command ability. Every unit can only receive 1 command ability per phase. And on top of that, each command ability can only be used once per phase. So although Inspiring Presence is still here, it can only be used once in the Battleshock phase. So even though Inspiring Presence is still here, it can now only be used once in the Battleshock phase. Number 4, changes to existing command abilities. Pretty much every existing command ability has changed by a certain degree. At the double, which allowed you to, after making a run roll, change the run roll into a 6, now doesn't let you make the run roll. You just have to declare it beforehand, this one's going to run 6. Furthermore, all out of attack is a +1 to hit, not rerolling 1s to hit. And you declare it when you go to attack, not at the beginning of the combat phase. All out defense is +1 to your saves, not reroll 1s to your save, and you declare it when you're declared as the target of an attack. So you don't have to declare it ahead of time. Now, before you think +1 to save, that's too powerful. First off, it is very powerful, but there is now a limit of not improving your save by more than 1. So if you have 2 ways to get +1 to your save and you're a 4-up save, it'll never be able to be improved to a 2-up save. Now, it can still help against rend, of course, but you're just never going to be able to improve your save by more than 1. Inspiring Presence and Forward to Victory, which allows you to reroll charges, haven't necessarily changed, but the limit of only being able to be used once per phase is a pretty big deal. If you have 2 units that you want to make long charges with, only one of them is going to be allowed to reroll. If you have 2 units that need to make Battleshock tests, well, now you can only Inspiring Presence one of them, which means that when you're fighting, there's now a benefit to spreading out your attacks between different units, because now your opponent will have to make multiple Battleshock tests rather than just saving a couple command points and passing them no matter what. Number 5, new command abilities. We've got 3 new command abilities, all 3 of which are pretty significant. First one is Rally. At the start of your hero phase, you can issue this command onto a unit that has suffered casualties. You roll a number of dice equal to how many casualties it has already suffered, and for every 6, you get to bring back one of those models. While it, of course, it'll help you to bring back the large units, it's the elite ones that I'm most interested in. You have those Blood Knights that have lost 3 of them. You roll 3 dice and you get 1 or 2 sixes, and you get to bring 1 or 2 of them back. That's a big deal. The second one in the movement phase is redeploy. After your opponent has moved a unit, if they move that unit within 9 inches of one of your own units, you can actually do the redeploy command ability on that unit and move them d6 inches. Now, this is going to be a little swingy, rolling a d6 anywhere from 1 to 6, but you can use it to move forward to stop a charge from getting too far forward, to move back to make the charge harder, or to redeploy and get them in front of something else that they would rather charge. There's a lot of other implications here that we haven't even explored yet. yet, and I'm sure we'll see pop up as we play more of this edition. The third one is in the charge phase. It is Unleash Hell. If you're familiar with Overwatch and 40K, it is similar, but maybe considerably more powerful. After a unit has finished a charge, a unit that is within 3 inches of the unit that charged, who's not already locked in combat with somebody else, is allowed to do the Unleash Hell command ability, which lets them fire their shooting weapons at the unit that just charged, with a -1 to their hit penalty. Now, it's a -1, as opposed to in 40K, where it's flat, you only get to roll on sixes to hit them. So this has been already very powerful in some of our test games. So those are the five big changes to command abilities and command points. Did I miss anything? Have you noticed any changes as well, especially if they've been talking about it in Warhammer community? What huge implications do you see from this? You can leave a comment below. And of course, we've got a battle report for all of our Vault members, another Age of Sigmar 3rd edition battle report for you, so you can see how these new rules are interacting. You'll see a lot of the command ability stuff, I can tell you that for sure, at the link in the description below. If you're not a Vault member, just remember you can go to that link, get a free 7-day trial, watch the battle report, and if you don't like anything else, you can cancel. We won't hold it against you. We do hope, of course, that you'll stick around to help support us. It is by our Vault members that we get to exist and have cool studios and lots of terrain and miniatures and make all these videos, both for our enjoyment and for yours. So please consider subscribing today. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more Age of Sigmar 3rd edition coverage. Happy Wargaming.